the people
standing top of their parliamentarians, and it's working quite well. It's a bit of a pity.
20 years or so.
And he has really this long breath. And if he has an unbelievable accent, he
wasn't allowed for German to be an official government institution. Because Western Berlin never belonged to Germany officially. It was a part of the Allied forces. And so that building had no function. But it was renovated.
Seems so.
Of the parliament. So this is more rational and it looks really like a
power plant.
Yeah, you don't know. What is it? Is it just an office building? Is it maybe a hospital?
Or a brewery, one of the two with those round cylinders.
I couldn't. George just did this for us. We like this a lot. It's hard to get this stuff going on Sunday morning. Normally you don't do this, but we're here.
Schloss
Maven. The scale of this thing.
Before he got president, it was here. It was here.
This is where the East exchanged the spies between East and West on this bridge. Going into East Germany. It used to be East Germany.
We later became Friedrich Wilhelm IV, the Prussian king. Together with him, they had the idea to transform the whole landscape around Potsdam into a landscape garden.
Wow.
Which is like a huge plan, but what an idea. What an ideal, so to say.
Yeah.
What an idealism. And they succeeded to realize it around the Klinika Bridge. So,
that's a beautiful shot. That's awesome. This is the Dutch part of Potsdam. The Dutch part of Potsdam.
You see the first houses of the so-called Dutch quarter.
Sure looks like it. The fronts are really nice.
Yes. Five stories.
This is before. This is after. Is it called Brandenburg?
It's called Brandenburg Gate, yes.
Wow. The gate is older than the original.
And yes, but only 20 years.
Well, hey, listen. If your building's 2 feet higher, right, you're higher.
We designed it as kind of a picturesque scenery for the Sanssouci Palais.
But of course. Wow. Just a sculptor, right?
Yes. Frederick the Great said that to this architect. He said, well, I have to build something like that because all my relatives need to represent. Because Frederick the Great being around that summer
Yes. This is a Chinese tea house of Frederick the Great. Look at this. Well, I guess this would make your tea taste better, right? Oh my gosh.
Yeah, it was the time when the Europeans discovered out-of-European areas like China.
Now it's 10 o'clock in the evening or
something. These are all vines. All for one. The guy, Frederick II, he died here, much beloved.
He's accompanied by his greyhounds and his beloved dog, the
And next to his greyhounds, he is buried there in his grave. And the greyhounds could understood only French.
Can see the places where the revolution in 1989 started in the one church. This is where I used to live. And it's also interesting just to walk around.
I get a picture of you jetting in here. Yeah, that's beautiful. This is the site they're preparing for a car bomb. We had the shutters down and immense security. Except for the bike out front. One next door, three or four as well. And this is our room right here, which we were watching all the diplomats leave this morning. That's it right there. 1, 2, 3. That's the bathroom. Left the light on. It's a beautiful place. Roof gardens.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
And the Russians fought it out for the very last
time. Really not in the beginning.
So in the beginning everybody was happy.
That
was
in the beginning it was really like an atmosphere of, I cannot tell you in other words, of friendship.
Yeah,
really a celebration, yeah. And everybody was, nobody thought about money. Yeah. And I think that was the biggest fault in the history of reunification, that Helmut Kohl at that time told the people, well, don't worry, it will cost you nothing. Because if he were honest at that time, and he knew that it will cost us billions of marks, yes, and later euros, and if he would have said that in 1989, everybody would have said, okay, that's the story. Now we're reunified and we give the money. It's okay.
Because these are our people, this is our family.
Right,
this is,
right.
Yeah. And it wasn't their fault that happened.
Right, and the fault was that he wasn't honest, and so everybody thought, okay, it's a double luck. It doesn't cost us anything, and we have the people. Yeah, and that in the end led to that situation that really a confrontation was made up between the East and the West, which is still existing, I have to say. The income in the former eastern parts of Germany are still lower than in the former western parts. And if you meet elder people who lived in the two systems, they still have this reserved attitude, oh, you're from the East, or oh, you're from the West, and the other way around. The younger, of course, they
don't care.